Now, the issue pertaining to the waste containers in Sri Lanka was discussed during the Face the Nation program last night.
This is nothing to do with recycling. This is simply garbage. What is happening here is, when you get the container from the Europe, you are paid with minimum $20,000 to $30,000. You bring it here just for the sake of BOI purposes, export certain few items back to some other part of the world, and use the same BOI dumping yard and dump in Sri Lanka, the balancer. I don't think there's any intention of recycling.
I also emphasize the fact that no Sri Lankan law at present allows any importation of any waste material. Although the CEA website says so, the website is in contradiction to the National Environment Act. So therefore, we have to all abide by the law. Even if the website is wrong, it does not mean that anyone can get an authority to import any garbage or waste material to this country. And the National Environment Act does not have any provision to allow any import of a waste material to this country. Therefore, if someone makes that interpretation, I should say it's bad in law or it is illegal, and that interpretation does not carry any weight.
I'm particularly mentioning this, the way that Haley's company has stored this waste material. It is open to air, open to the elements, rain drops on it, it's moldy, liquids are, seeping out. Now, any proper recycler or processor or whoever needs to have proper storage facilities as the minimum to start an operation like this. So the BOI is also responsible, I think, in order to make sure that, these BOI-approved companies have these limited facilities. And the company itself has done a really, really bad job. So I'm sad to say, Haley's cannot get away so easily and say this is somebody else's job, business. All around our coasts, we have a huge plastic problem. Our oceans are, grossly polluted with plastic. So we already have a huge problem of waste. And on top of that, if we are actually importing waste like this, we are, through various means, waste is smuggled. Now, Sri Lanka is one of the top 10 plastic polluters in the world. Maybe, who knows, maybe this is plastic that is coming from the developing countries, which are dumped to our landfill and to our oceans. Who knows?
I have a doubt why the Aruwakkaru is being quickly transformed into a dumping yard in the recent past. Whether Aruwakkaru operation is part and parcel of this operation is also, we don't know. They would have planned just to make sure you get the garbage in, produce some sort of a few items to the BOI to say that we are re-exporting, and take the majority of the stuff to Aruwakkaru.
We should take immediate action to send back this cargo to that particular destination. The investigation is sufficient enough to move for a customs inquiry. Most probably within a very few days, we can go for a customs inquiry and we can penalize the persons and we can come to a conclusion. But we want to make this land a better place to live for you, me, and to the entire human beings. As a citizen, we have obligation. As a business person, we have obligation. As a government servant, we have obligation.
Now, meanwhile, a group of university lecturers revealed details about the disposal of garbage in Jaffna.
Clinical waste.
We have received information that clinical waste has been brought to Jaffna. We suspect that they are attempting to dispose garbage here. Facilities have been set to dump foreign waste. How did a container carrying waste material arrive at the Thellipalai hospital?